Hi, I'm Paul Shin. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, the most boomer-oriented car channel in all of YouTube, and proud of it. So I get a lot of comments in some of my videos where I've posted things where I'm like discussing how a Model A drives and comparing it to a Prius, or Toyota Prii for plural. And I get a lot of hate mail. People say, why are you hating on the Priuses or Prii so much? What is it with you and Priuses? And they get offended and say lots of things, and my moderators have to go through and clean up the comments because they're not G-rated anymore after they complain about that. So I guess it's time that I share something with you very, very private. This is a 2014 Toyota Prius Hybrid. It is, by any comparison, the polar opposite of a Ford Model A. This was the 11th year for the Prius and the third generation of Toyota's Prius design. Known for its roomy interior and jelly bean-like styling, the Prius is not built to be pretty. It's a generic people mover appliance. Sporting a 4-cylinder, 1.8-liter gasoline engine, coupled with two electric motors connected to a 202-volt nickel-metal hydride battery bank, for a combined effect of 134 horsepower, the Prius would be relatively sporty, if not for its weight. You could say the Prius has a windshield of a 1978 Lamborghini Countach, and you'd be almost correct. Lacking curvature of any kind, minimal design flamboyance, it's no wonder the Prius is the vehicle of choice for most every Karen. Unlike the Model A, which causes Karens to transform into normal people, the Prius empowers them. Both of these machines do one simple thing very easy. They get people from point A to point B. How they do that is a whole different matter. Now, in the Model A, which is what I'm used to driving, having just driven this as a daily driver for a little over a year, I'm used to bare basics. I can get in a Model A, I look at the dash layout, I look at all the controls, I know what it all does. I step foot in the Prius, I could be in the space shuttle. I don't know. I know what some of it does. And having read the manual and looked online, I know what a little bit more of it does. But I don't really know how it works. So my brain tells me if I had to drive cross country right now, if I got in this, I know I could get there. And if something were to happen along the way, I would know how to get myself out of trouble. I could be completely self-sufficient. If I drive across country in this and something were to happen, I'm really lost. Then I'm just like all those other YouTube guys that have to take their car to a shop and don't know anything about how it works. I'm no better than those guys. But here, I'm a little bit better. Just a little. The first weirdness you notice about being inside a Toyota Prius is this is the key. You don't even have an actual key that you plug into something. It's just this thing that somehow talks to the Spaceship Enterprise Command Center here and tells it you're in the car to go ahead and go. So if this is somewhere in the car, it could be in your pocket, wherever, you just close the door, press the start button, and then the car tells you, okay, let's go. No motor, no nothing, no advance the spark, no pull the choke, nothing. So you put your seatbelt on, the car says, okay, let's go. I don't know, again, this is the exact opposite of a Ford Model A. So to put this in gear, it's this little gear shift thing here, and you just go like that, now it's in drive, it says. So if I take my foot off the brake, the Prius begins to move. Now, of course, this is not me driving a car. This is not a Model A where I'm doing everything. This is me asking a computer to please do something, and then the computer says, you know what, yeah, maybe I'll let you. I'll do it. You just sit there. I'll do it. So imagine somebody from 1931 going forward in time and seeing a Prius. Imagine if you could take a Prius back in time and show Henry Ford and say, look, this is the car of the future. They wouldn't think you were from the future. They would think you're from outer space. Okay, this thing is like eerily quiet. You could totally sneak up on people in this. This car is quiet like that one micromanager boss you used to have that would sneak up on you to see if you're really working or not. This is what he would drive. So is a Prius fast? Not really. In fact, I was kind of thinking, you know, I bet a Model A could outrun a Prius. So I figured I'd find out. So I got a hold of my friend Dave, who's a Prius owner. And I said, hey, Dave, you know, we're both almost at retirement age, but mentally we're both in our teens. I said, hey, Dave, how about a race? You drive the Prius and I'll drive the Model A. Let's go. And Dave, no hesitation, is like, yeah, tell me when and where. Let's go right now. So this is what happened. The Prius's 134 horsepower beat the 40 horsepower Model A, but admittedly, not by that much. So I don't know. Right now, it makes a lot of sense to drive this car. No question. But you start thinking, a Model A is 90 years old. What's this car going to be in 90 years? Probably going to be in a big tire fire somewhere. The Prius is advertised to get up to 50 miles per gallon, but in reality, the Prius gets mid-20s, maybe high 20s at best. The Model A gets a consistent 24, 25 miles per gallon, so the Model A is not burning any more fuel than the Prius, but one thing's for sure, the Model A is a lot more environmentally friendly when you consider the manufacturing impacts. Want to get a cool shirt like this one? Gopherwear.com, gopherwear.com, link in the description below. Super good quality material and shirts. I just love their shirts, and of course, as soon as I saw one with a Model A on it, you know I had to get that. So gopherwear.com, get your own. Check it out. Okay, so let's wrap this up. So is the Prius a car worthy of ridicule? It's somehow beneath the Model A? No, absolutely not. The Prius is a great car. There's no question. It's going to be reliable. It's going to get you from point A to point B. And yeah, okay, I compare it to a Model A because it is the polar opposite of a Ford Model A. It is the exact opposite in terms of technology, in terms of the way it's built, in terms of the way it's shaped, everything. There is nothing that it has in common with a Model A, except maybe that it has four tires and it will get you from point A to point B. That's where the similarity ends. So yes, I compare the Ford Model A against a Toyota Prius because they are polar opposites. So with that said, I do have a man card to keep, and officially, this Prius, I'm done with it. It is for sale. So first 10 grand, get yourself a really low mileage, really clean Toyota Prius. Hit me up, paul@paulshen.us, if you want a really clean Toyota Prius with almost no miles on it. Thanks so much. Catch you on the next video. Merry Christmas.
Huge thanks goes out to the donors for this channel. Thank you to those special people that have donated and helped keep this channel running. We have lots more to do and lots of rebuilding of Model A's coming up. So please click below in the description. You'll find the link to donate to this channel. And thank you so much.